Okay. Yes, Kenneth, you got to do your piece all over again.
Okay. Hello, everyone. My name is Kenneth. I'm the host for Mother Industrialist live show. And today I have this awesome guest. Her name is Goh Wan Pin. I got to know Goh Wan Pin from a friend, our mutual friend Jack. And I was sharing with Jack about my book, Mother Industrialist, Perfecting the Balance Between Motherhood and Business Success. And the first person that she thought of as was a mompreneur, which is Goh Wan Pin. And he immediately connected us, and I'm so excited now because I get to invite Goh Wan Pin for my first episode. She's the first mompreneur to appear on this show. And let's welcome Goh Wan Pin.
Hey, thank you. Thanks, Kenneth. And thank you, Taiba and Carol, and all those who commented to let us know that my audio wasn't going through. So yeah. Thanks for having me on the show, Kenneth.
It's yeah, welcome.
Really exciting. It's an honor to be the first guest.
Yeah. Please start. So thanks. Maybe you can share with the audience that what does heartpreneur mom means, and also prior to you starting on business and being a coach, what are you doing previously?
Well, that's going to be a long answer. Well, the Heartpreneur Mom is the name of my brand. And so I work with moms who are entrepreneurs. But more importantly, I like to support those who are heart-centered, because I believe that following your heart in whatever you do is so important as a mom, and even more important as an entrepreneur. So that's my brand. I've been an entrepreneur since 2009. So it's been quite a long time.
Almost. Wow.
Yeah. Before that, I had a very nice like corporate career. My mom told me when I was young, study hard, get a good job. I really did. I was a very good student, studied hard, went to good schools. I had good jobs. I had jobs that took me around the world doing the thing I love, which is marketing, branding, and business development.
Mm.
So corporate life was great for me at that point when I was single. But at a point after more than 10 years, what my mom didn't tell me is that I would reach a point where this dream job of mine no longer seemed to fulfill my purpose in life. So I went on to do something very crazy, which nothing in my family had ever done before. I left my job and I became an entrepreneur.
Oh.
I started my own company. But seriously, on hindsight, right, at that point of time, I really didn't know what I was getting myself into. So it was a very, very steep learning curve. Mm. It was a water business, so a retail and distribution business. So my business partner and I built something up from zero awareness in Singapore. Now there's more than 13 outlets all over Singapore.
Wow. So
that's something that I'm proud of. But it at some point, that didn't suit my lifestyle as well, because I was a mom of two children at the time I had that business.
Wow.
Yeah. So I've since exited that company, and I went ahead to look for a way that would work for me as a mother.
Mm.
And so that's why now I am a business coach. I realized that over the years, I learned how to design my life such that I actually can have everything I want. A successful career, a very blissful family. I'm a mother of three children.
Mm.
And I am able also to contribute to my favorite charities that are very close
wow.
to
me. The heart to give back is really wonderful, right?
Yeah. So being able to do that made me realize that getting that all for myself wasn't enough at some point. So I wanted to be able to help more mothers get that as well. And that's why I became a business coach. It fits in perfectly with my current lifestyle, because my two older children are 11 and 9.
Wow.
I'm 2 year old.
So, wow.
Yeah, it's a very big gap in between. And the 2 year old is who I spend the most time with now.
Yeah. I saw some of your live video. You had your youngest daughter, right?
Yes. Yeah.
So maybe you can share with us that you were saying that you were doing corporate, and suddenly you make that switch to become an entrepreneur. You start your first business.
Yeah.
What was the reason or the aha moment that you decided to really, okay, you want to leave the corporate job and you want to start your own business? And why into coaching or why into the business that you initially started?
Yeah. So that was 9, 10 years ago. Mm. No. 2009. Yeah, okay. So about 8 years ago. You know what, Kenneth? I didn't have an aha moment. I would tell you, you know, like there was this fantastic moment where you know, everything just fell into place and it all clicked. I didn't.
Wow.
I left my work because I knew I was unhappy within it and I wasn't able to be the mom I wanted to be. And I went into business because I thought at that point of time so naively that I could have more control over my time and my timing could be more flexible. So that was what appealed to me. So I had no idea what I was getting myself into. I didn't think that it was going to be so tough. And yeah, so there wasn't an aha moment. It was basically like just, okay, I left my job. I had to take the plunge. I committed together with my business partner. And like, I've just got to get this done. So that's why I said the initial learning curve was really, really steep for me because I had no idea why I was doing business for. So I was unhappy, quite burnt out, and felt as though it was a mistake. You know, I still wasn't getting the time with my family and yet I was undergoing a lot more stress compared to being in a corporate role where I would just get my salary at the end of every month, which I really missed when the initial years of being an entrepreneur. So that was 8 years back.
Wow.
I think the time where I truly embraced entrepreneurship was when my children got a little bit older and I was able to have that focus to do something and learning from some online gurus, realizing that I can actually be starting an online business, following my heart and following what I want to do. Now, I want to add value to other people. I don't want to hard sell. I don't want to use like not really pleasant online techniques to get people to buy stuff. So yeah, when I realized that, I knew that was something, a window for me where I could do my business the way I wanted to and yet be able to fulfill all my other roles in life. So that was when I became a business coach. That was last year.
Last year, you officially become a business coach.
Yeah.
But before that, you were doing just mainly all your online business.
Yeah, online retail. I did some online retail. I was involved in network marketing as well. Mm. I even expanded my network marketing business to Yangon, Myanmar.
Wow. And,
like, you know, just dabble in everything, attempting to look for a way that would work for me. Mm. You know, so funny because you might be surprised. Hey, why did I only start my coaching business last year, right? You know, it didn't even occur to me that I could be teaching someone the things that I knew until my coach, Imran, and my coaches, Imran and Faz, they just pointed out to me, and that's what coaches are really good for. They are able to see things that I wasn't able to see. So they just pointed out to me that, hey, you've had years of experience and you know how to make things work while taking care of your family and your role as a mom. Why don't you share that information? And that was really the starting point of where I realized I could actually add value and cut down a lot of trial and error and time wasted for mothers who want to do the same.
Wow.
You know, I spent a lot of time experimenting until I came to this point. But now I'm helping moms to cut down all that stuff and then just dive straight into what they want to do.
Wow. That is really, that's why I started this live show, basically to invite guests who are really entrepreneurial and entrepreneur like you who's giving back and also helping a lot of mothers to shorten the learning curve, because like for you, I believe that the time when you started doing online, a lot of things are very new. You have to do test and trial, and yes, most importantly is a lot of money into it,
exactly,
into testing things that is not working.
Yeah.
And now you are using all that and giving back to all the mothers. Why is that relation, meaning that why you feel that is a necessary thing that you want to do to shorten the learning curve for mothers?
Well, because the thing that we don't have and are losing every minute and second is time. We can always make money back, right?
Yep.
So that's not tricky at all, but we can't get time back. And we have heard up 10 times parents telling us they really miss the time when their children were young.
Yes.
They could turn back the clock. They wish they were there for their children during like the important milestones, but you can't turn back time. So that's the, you know, that was the regret that I had with my first two children. So my first two children, I was running my business and I did miss a lot of their milestones.
Yeah.
With this number three, it's a total reminder that I can build my life around spending time with her, enjoying her milestones, but yet no need to compromise what I want to do.
All right.
But that takes commitment.
Yes.
It takes skill set. It takes discipline, and it takes quite a number of different things that, you know, like in a corporate world I wouldn't have learned. And even in my initial years of entrepreneurship, I wouldn't have learned that. So that's where I feel is my expertise and this knowledge and experience sharing with young moms who are still starting out.
Yes.
And really just, you know, like the kind of peace of mind, you are a father, you are a husband, you would know that if your wife said she wanted to do something, you'd be worried, what if she cannot juggle? What if she drops some balls, right?
Yes.
What if she loses a lot of money or she becomes very unhappy in the process?
Yep.
Those are the exact things that if there's someone to guide the mom along, you totally cut down these things.
All right.
So that's why I'm so committed, just like you. And that's why I think you do so well. And I think it's so precious coming from a father and husband standpoint.
Yeah, thank you.
You are spreading a message that's so important to women. And even there are not even enough women talking about it.
Yes.
Stand up as a man, a father, and a husband to say, hey, you know, women out there, moms, you can have a fulfilling business and a fulfilling life as a mother as well. I think that's awesome. So you must tell the audience about your book later on.
In fact, why I do this live show, because in fact, a lot of audiences or those that are a fan of my fan page, they may not know, because I always get this question whenever I start talking about my book is, why is a man writing a book about mothers?
Exactly.
So, so it's practically everyone, especially mothers, is asking me, what has it got to do with you? Aren't you supposed to write something on that pruno and promote it about that pruno?
Yes.
And that's why my publisher want me to write this, because he realized that as you were sharing that there's not a mompreneur that's writing a book on mompreneur, because, and that also leads back to my subtitle of my book, which is perfecting the balance between motherhood and business success. And after interviewing so many mompreneurs for my book, I interviewed like 20 of them, and I realized and I found out the answer, which is because once they have that balance, their time is full. Their 24 hours is used up. So they won't have the extra time, because to them that is very precious, to be able to balance business and family and parenting together. So it's enough for you. And that's where, for me as a third party, from one person that's stepping out and looking at it, it's a clearer view. And furthermore, it leads back to about 9 to 10 years where I started in my advertising sales. I was selling ad space for a parenting magazine, local parenting magazine. And that's where most of my clients, they are mothers. And I'm like surrounded with mothers. And back then, I was a new dad. My daughter was born. And we because parents love to share and we exchange ideas and tips and stuff. So I got very close to them. And even to today, we still kept in contact, although in the past 8 to 9 years I've been like changing industry or maybe changing company. But because of the parenting, as friends, we see our children grow up. Now most of our children are about 8 to 9 years old. In the primary school, we have another topic again. And all thanks to Facebook, we are still in keeping in contact. And we see how tall our children are growing. And in fact, a lot of my mompreneur friends, they are having their third child. Like for you, the age gap is pretty huge. Yes. And it's because you are able to balance your business and your family.
Yeah.
At this point. And when everything is balanced, you don't have to worry about money, which because your business can give you. And if you build a system around the business, you basically you don't have too much of the financial side. On the other hand, because you're of your own business, you're taking charge and you're living life on your own terms where the time comes from. And like for you, now your third child, at the age of 2, you can have her as and when in your business. It does not affect your business, which is something that I want to share with all the audience, especially mothers who wanted to step out to this, step into an entrepreneurship to start a business, that is possible because all of you have done it, and the 20 mompreneurs that I interviewed have done it. And upcoming in all this, in this Mother Industry show, I'm going to invite mothers, mompreneurs from all around the world, which I'm having them on the show. And I'm so glad that I'm able to invite them to share about their journey and how they step into the entrepreneurship.
Yeah. You know, it's a wonderful mission that you're having, and I'm so honored to be part of this movement that you're having to encourage moms to have the courage to take the step out into entrepreneurship. And I've never taken the stand that entrepreneurship is for everyone, but for mothers who have this tingling feeling in them, you know, something in them that says there must be something more to my life than this, and they want to pursue something else. Entrepreneurship is one of the most fulfilling and satisfying journeys. You know, it reminds me of when my daughter was in primary one. So that was easily like 10, 11 years ago. So I sat down to have a family meeting, and I told her that all of us at home have our own roles to play. So her going to primary one, her new role is a student, daddy's role is a dentist, and mommy's role is a businesswoman. And auntie's role, so our helper with us at that time, is a role to take care of everything at home. So for us for everything to work around the household, all of us have to be focused on doing our roles. So I told her, like, how would you feel, what would happen to mommy's role if I were to help you be a student? Right? So like help you do your homework or remind you about packing your bag and stuff like that. And she said, then you won't be able to do your work well. So yes, exactly. So if I asked her to come and help me in my business, then she won't be able to do her role well. And this was a very important and pivotal conversation that I had with her, that really set the context for everything to follow. So my role is not only a mom. I'm also a wife, I'm a daughter, I'm a woman. So there are areas where I also need to be self-expressed. I have a passion that's close to heart. And if I devote myself only to that motherhood role and nothing else, for me, I found that there was something missing. And having said that, for all the stay-home moms who are devoting their time and lives to their children and family, I'm not saying you are not doing a good job. So if you're happy with what you're doing, and actually that's the most important, if you're happy with what you're doing, continue doing it. So it's perfect. But I wasn't happy. So I was the type, right, who I knew I couldn't be a full-time mom. I also couldn't be a full-time employee, right? So I really wanted a mixture of both. Perhaps it's in my personality that I needed change, you know, a bit of excitement in life that I wouldn't get too bored with. I'm not sure. But that I knew was what could make me happier. And therefore, with the blessings of my family and the support of all the people at home, everyone taking care of their own roles means I can go pursue my role as well. And that's what made me more empowered as a mother. Mm. I go out there, I have good days and I have bad days.
Yes,
so
definitely.
When I'm bad days, right, I'm telling my daughter, I'm telling my children about it, and I can relate to how they feel sometimes when they think, why should I be studying? I feel like giving up. I feel I can't get a good grade I want to aim for. And you know, if I weren't doing my business, I'll just sit there and say, no lah, dear, you must work hard. You know, you must aim for the best and don't give up. All that would be just lip service.
Yeah.
I am showing them by pure example that mommy doesn't give up.
Yeah.
Year after year, different businesses, I didn't give up. And when I reach a point today where I can show them, look, I'm reaping the fruits of my determination and my commitment, and that's what it takes, I feel like I'm giving them the best life skills they can ever have to take them into the future world next time.
Yes,
It's very challenging, right?
Right.
It's no longer like a paper degree or anything like that. It's enough. Our children are having such a good life. It's so hard to even simulate challenges. So these are the ways where I can show and empower them as an individual, and then be able to stand in my strength as a mother, so they can never say, but mommy, you don't know what I'm talking about. What?
Well, yeah.
See, mommy does it more than you.
Correct, correct.
That's the kind of thing that on hindsight, I felt that, you know, I went into entrepreneurship just to serve other moms, but I realized all the benefits that I reap later on, right, is to really help me be a better mother.
Yes, yes. Yeah. That's what leading to our topic of today,
yep.
Where it's how entrepreneurship has made you a better mom. Yeah. Maybe you can share with the audiences out here, mm-hmm. and why has it make it better?
Yeah. So that was one of the aspects that, because I got to do the things that I love, right? I'm able to be the person I want to be. That makes me a happier person, and I can be a better mom that way. I'm not grouchy. I'm not complaining. I'm not grudging about my life. I am very happy in my life. The other thing you mentioned earlier, that, you know, when a lot of mompreneurs, when we juggle business and motherhood, there's hardly any time left.
Yes.
4 hours. That brings me to another point, that because it forces me to plan so much more than usual, I am working on a day-to-day basis based on intention rather than action.
Yes.
So I could be a mom and not doing very much, and I would have quite a bit of time on my hands. But because I'm also pursuing business, my time is truly limited. I really would have to be so protective of my time and plan it so well that I only use it for all the worthy places.
Yeah.
Which means, right, when I can be wasting a lot of time on social media, like idling on social media, or going out and having idle chats with my friends complaining about their mother-in-laws and their helpers, I am focusing my time on the things that I deem are most important. And over time, that's a very precious habit to have. I'm passing on these time management and productivity skills not only to other mompreneurs, but to my children as well. Yeah, so I'm like not telling them what to do, but I'm giving them certain guidelines and say, if you want this outcome, then... Oh, and the other thing about also understanding their why, I teach my children that as well.
You mean for your kids or for mothers?
Both. I coach that in my program for the mompreneurs, but I do that for my children too, because it really sets the foundation for everything. Oh, why do they need to study hard? Because they want to get good grades. Why do they want to get good grades? To make my mom happy. Okay, well, that's not for you. You can totally just chill and not need to study anymore. So it's really to help them be more aware. They may not get it. They may be a little bit too young to go fully into that concept. But Kenneth, I learned over the years that never underestimate my children's ability to understand these things.
Yes.
They pick it up so much faster than us.
Correct.
I realized over the years. So I actually impart these skill sets to them that I've been using myself and found that has worked for me. So it's been really precious. These gifts that I pass on to other mompreneurs, and they can pass on to their children.
Yes.
I can pass on to my children as well. And it's the foundation of life skills. I'm not too concerned how my children perform academically.
Mm.
I would be upset if they showed me the like twisted values, or they are not acting based on kindness and consideration for other people. That would make me upset.
All right.
If they didn't do well in school, I will actually see and ask them if they did their best and they actually perform based on their highest potential. Yep. If they have, then so be it, right? Some people take longer to bloom, some people don't. But you know what? It really doesn't matter. So those are the areas that I felt that if I didn't become an entrepreneur, I didn't walk this path myself and go through all the setbacks and obstacles and realize my own internal strengths and resources, I would never be able to apply these things to my mothering journey.
Mm.
Yeah. So that's why I think it's been so amazing. Like what you start off and expecting to get,
yeah,
later on you'll just get back so much more.
Correct. Like you share, I really resonate with you, because like the part where you say about the life skill, being an entrepreneur, make you a better mom. In fact, all this life skill, you pass it down to your children and they learn it. And this is a part that I wrote in my book about the future. Are we parents planning for our children's future?
Yes.
And I can say that if you, as an entrepreneur, you can pass down the skills, which I call survival skill. Mm. And because academic-wise, they can always catch up, they can always go for further studies and all that. But one thing they can build on is their soft skills,
yes,
their survival skill, their thinking,
yes,
their mindset. This is something I learned recently, which is called grit. Grit, G-R-I-T. That means the persistence to really pull through hardship and a lot of that.
Yes, yes.
And this is something that only that I saw from Mompreneur, they are able to pass down this skill. Yes. And that's why I'm very, very into advocating entrepreneurship. Although entrepreneurship is not for all mothers, for those who are seeking a way, like for you, that you don't see yourself being a corporate job, you want to get out from the rat race, you are sick and tired of changing job, you do not know what's your purpose in life, then entrepreneurship may be the way for you to really find out, to really pursue, and not just for yourself, also for your children. Like for you, you have passed out a lot of values, a lot of life skills that your children can take with them when they grew up. These are things that they may be at a better advantage than other kids. Because other kids are just schooling, studying. Everybody is doing the same. And if you look at today's world, a lot of students graduated, they have the degree, you have a degree, everybody has a degree.
Yep.
But what if like my daughter, she's 8 years old, 15 years later, she will graduate with a degree, with a master degree. She will look around, "Daddy, there's no job for me." Because everybody is being a master degree.
Yes,
there's nothing special. And at a look at it now, the economy, with AI, with internet, with technology coming in, a lot of job now is going to be replaced.
Yes.
And what is going to happen in 15 years time?
Mm.
Where we already seeing a lot of changes in the past 3 years and even upcoming the 3 to 5 years. Even for us as adults, as parents, we are losing jobs. A lot of my friends in mid-30s, they got retrenched because the industry they are in is no longer around, which is something they studied like maybe 15 years ago to become what they are.
Yeah.
So what is the future up for our children?
Hmm.
So this is something that I'm very concerned about, and I feel that through Mompreneur entrepreneurship, is able to address this issue. Like for you, you are addressing that. And a lot of my mompreneur, they are bringing the entrepreneurship, they are getting their children involved, having fun in building the business together, which is something I see it, which I want to share it with all the mothers out there who, to let them know more about entrepreneurship, just letting them see the other side, whether is it suitable for them. If not, they can always stay in the job that they are happy about. But if they are not happy, entrepreneurship will be another alternative for them.
Mm, Exactly. I think because in our society, we were brought up like just thinking that after you graduate, you should go and get a good job, right? And nobody told us what if we didn't like our jobs after some time.
Yep.
Or what if our jobs didn't need us after some time?
Yes.
And that's the reality that's happening a lot these couple of years.
Yep.
What you mentioned earlier is like really for survival. If they had a skill set that allows them to be able to make income through their own business, that would totally help, right? But the other thing also, and that's why I'm passionate about being a heartpreneur mom, is that what is it that makes your heart sing, right? What is that thing that your heart really wants to do? And because of the technology advancements these days, and that's why I'm able to do my work online, right? All these technology help us sort of like scale down or bring down eliminate all the obstacles that would otherwise be in our way if we wanted to start a business years back, right? Like 10, 20 years ago, if we wanted to do this, it was really, really much tougher.
Yes.
But now it's so easy. You have a passion, you have a message, you can just go out there and bring it out to the world. Like young children, teenagers are already doing that.
Yep.
So if we are able to embrace just these concepts, right? And we are not even talking about the need to have huge, huge financial success with it. So don't put yourself like thinking that, oh, you know, like I don't think I can make that much money out of it. But it's a lot more than only the money.
Yes.
So the money helps, definitely. But the other experiences that you get as a person and what you pass on to your children, and actually, you know, our children don't listen to us. Mothers listening out there. Our children and our husbands too. Most of the time, they don't listen to us. Our children learn from what they see us doing.
Yes.
And that's the most crucial thing. Like, I do still do have my indulgence of online shopping, watching my Korean drama and all that, right? Some de-stress things, but I do know as well, sometimes I'll be listening to podcasts during my free time. I'll be watching Shark Tank with them. There is a balance that I'm striking. So it's not that I have to be that perfect mother.
All right.
In fact, my entrepreneurship journey has just shown them how imperfect I am. And yet, because I'm imperfect, then I just need to do my best and keep learning and just doing and not give up, right?
All
so
right.
These are a couple of like basic things that I'm showing them by example. And I think that's really, really precious. I mean,
I'm
grateful that I have the opportunity to be able to do that. Not all mothers can. And that's why I feel it's also very important, not only for fathers like you to stand up and speak for a mompreneur, but also for mothers, mompreneurs to get together and support one another.
Yes.
It's already difficult enough as it is. And
life
happens. A lot of times our businesses get interrupted because of things that happen in life. Guess what? We don't only need to take care of our children. We have our parents. We have our in-laws. We have our husbands. There are many roles that we play in our lives.
Yep.
And businesses may not need to be only resting on your shoulders. We are looking at collaboration, joint venture. I find that circle of support that a mom has in terms of her business and her network, her private mastermind, right? That's really, really important as well. So sometimes your family don't understand, or sometimes they object even. So how do you really like keep on going during times like that? It's really the people around you. So you're doing such an awesome job, but you know what? Like, because you're doing so awesome, right? I want to just tell the mompreneurs out there that, hey, we got to rise up. You know, like, why are we having another father and husband to speak up for us? So, yeah. So I'm going to pull more mompreneurs to be like part of your league and your team to be able to spread this movement together with you. Yeah, I think we really need that.
Yeah, I guess it's not about me stepping out or me taking the role of the mompreneur. It's because of my past 9 to 10 years seeing a lot of mompreneur, because I see both sides, which is my friends was in the corporate job and also the mompreneur. And a lot of my friends who are mothers, they are like struggling from the guilt of not having time with your children and struggling and so exhausted after the whole year of work, and the children just want some time. Mommy, you're back. I want to have some hug. And most of the time, the mothers are, can you leave me alone? I'm so tired. So when I see that and I felt that struggle in them, and it's not just 1 or 2 years, it's like for the past 10 years, it's a cycle. And I see most of the mompreneurs that I work with, they are having that relief because they are in control. They're able to allocate time. And this is something that one of the mompreneurs shared with me, that she don't work on her business. She work around the business, meaning that she don't really focus on the business. She focus on the family, the husband, the in-laws, all the time being allocated before she worked on the business. But a lot of mompreneurs, they jump in and just work on the business instead of around the business. That's why a lot of them tell me, Kenneth, you tell me to step into business, but in the end, I'm even more time broke. But is that not the case? Because it's how you manage your business, how you work around your business. Because the key thing for mompreneur is basically the balance. If you want to start a business, you just want to earn money, then it's a separate thing. Then parenting, you cannot juggle. So, and you were saying that having a group of mompreneurs to come in as a movement is what I wanted. So that is to show a lot of moms they're struggling. Because there's a lot of myth, like example, also they say, oh, Kenneth, I don't have money to start a business, I do not have the time, I do not have the network, I do not have the business idea, I do not have this, do not have that. In fact, a lot of mompreneurs I know, they do not have any of this. They have only one thing, which is why you say the why. The why is to be able to spend more time with their children, their loved one, without worrying about time and money. And that's the key thing. And if you look at like what you're doing now, you're basically building a business online. And you also mentioned that 20, 30 years ago, our parents, our grandparents do not have this luxury of technology, internet. Like now what we're doing, basically, you're at your home, my home, we are doing this conversation through Facebook Live. All these things is possible because of internet, because of technology. And it gives a lot of people, especially mothers, stay-home mom especially, to be able to start a business from their home. And all this is possible with very minimum budget. And I believe that for you, you advise a lot of mommies or the mompreneurs to how they can start at a very, very minimum cost. Build it on a part-time basis until it grew to a full-time income. Then you can say bye-bye to your corporate job and stuff like that. Or if you still love your corporate job, you still can let your part-time business still rolling. And you still can build your business at the same time.
Yeah, I think you brought out such important points. In fact, we may think that many mompreneurs have it all sorted out, worked out, and we are like in total control. Actually, it's far from it most of the time. But that's how we train ourselves up to be more resilient over time. But the other thing is, that's why even mompreneurs, if you go from a job to a business and you treat your business like how you treated your job, and you put that kind of pressure over you yourself, that's where burnout and like being disillusioned and feeling like giving up would come into play. But that's why for me, I always make sure that the moms I coach know what their why is. And sometimes they did know it, but they forget. Life just catches up and it's so easy to forget why they started doing this in the first place. So mompreneurs need a certain skill set. Like I said, you can do the exact same thing as other entrepreneurs, but we need to do it in a shorter time, or we need to do it in like, you know, bursts of time where we get like some 30 minutes, 20 minutes in between where our children not bed yet or babies napping, all that sort of thing. That's how we mompreneurs work, right? And that's a different skill set that's required.
All right.
And it's what I want to tell the other moms who are considering sitting on the fence. Yes, it's not easy. And we don't have all the answers, and like not like we have it, we have everything perfect and sorted out.
Yeah.
But the fact that we took a first step out, and that, you know, I stand, and there are many other mompreneur coaches out there who stand for coaching you so that you can shorten your learning curve and get results a lot faster. then the only reason or the only thing that's stopping you is you, right? You and your little voice that tells you you can't do this. And it's definitely not an age thing.
it's not an
experience thing, not a time thing, not like tech geek, like I'm not a geek kind of
person. Right.
I don't know how to use computer, whatever, right?
Yeah.
All those are just excuses.
All right.
Really, I really encourage the moms who are considering this. Like, if you're tuning into this show, just start exploring, start being open. That's all we are asking. You don't need to dive into business tomorrow and then later freak out about what's it all entails, just like how I did, right? So I did it the wrong way, so don't follow that way. But just start having some conversations. And Kenna's program is a twice a week show, which is a perfect platform for you to enter the world of all the different mompreneurs out there.
Yes.
So we are all doing different businesses. So all right. Like online, or you're like thinking, yo, I cannot be like her and then put myself in front of video or camera. Yeah, then don't be. Your mompreneurs who are not doing that and they're still doing a good business. So there's always a way to explore. Follow Kenna's program to listen and get inspired by all the different mompreneurs and start getting in touch with him in the conversations. And yeah, just open up. Yeah.
Thank you, Goh Wan Pin. So I think we have run the show for about almost an hour, although some technical glitch. Yeah. So I really thanks Goh Wan Pin for coming on tonight. And there's something special about this show, which is because you are the first guest, you get to ask a question to the audience that are watching now or those who are watching replay. And this question will be posted to the next guest. And before the next guest start, the next guest has to answer the question and give us the answer before they go into the show.
Wow.
So you have that privilege because you are the first person, you are not asked a question. So do post a question to the audience, and for those who are watching on live or watching replay, put your answer in the comments below. Then we will definitely answer and definitely check it out. And also, your question will be posed to the next guest, and you know who's the next guest.
Yes, I do.
Yeah. So maybe you can have some time to think about the question you're going to pose.
Yeah. I think I got it now. I think it's more applicable to mompreneurs who or just women who have a passion or fire in their hearts. So between your passion and your children, which would you choose and why?
Wow. So between your passion and your children.
Yep.
Which one would you choose?
Yeah.
Okay, that's a very good question. And for those who are watching, do post your answer below in the comments area.
Yeah.
And at the same time, do check out the website, as you can see below. It's www.motherindustrialistbook.com. Mm-hmm. And grab a free copy of my book. And also stay tuned for our next Mother Industry Live show, which is going to happen this Friday.
Yep.
Do check out my fan page and all the schedule will be there. And thanks, Goh Wan Pin, for tonight. And before we end, Goh Wan Pin, do you have any things that you want to share with them? Maybe to check where they can check out more info about yourself and about Heartpreneur Mom.
Okay. Well, they can, for anybody who's watching and not my following me on Facebook yet, I have a personal Facebook page under the name Goh Wan Pin, and I have a business page titled The Heartpreneur Mom as well. So you can follow me there, like the page. I have private groups for mothers and mompreneurs, so you can check that out when you visit my pages. You can also drop by my website, which is www.theheartpreneurmom.com. Mm. So all that's quite easy to find. But I think besides that, when I was Kenneth before the interview sent me some questions for me to sort of get an idea and prepare for this interview, there was one question that he asked, like, what are the 5 top tips that I would give to a mompreneur?
Mm.
I did prepare those, but I only have one tip out of the 5 that I feel it's important to communicate with everyone, be it you're a mom or not yet an entrepreneur. And that's love your family every day.
Wow.
So are you giving your husband, your children a hug and a kiss at least once every single day? So that's what I'm putting forth. That's something that I do plenty of times a day.
Yeah, I agree with you, because it's a family should be full of love. You should be showering them with love, because you should treasure every moment. Yeah. And especially whether you're a mompreneur or you're just a mom, working mom. All this love has to be spread, because you want your child to be growing up in a very positive, very lovely, full of love environment. Because the world out there, as all of us know as adults, is pretty cruel and pretty negative. But that's where home should be, and you want your kids to come back home happily in the, our parents' hearts and our chests, all that.
Yeah.
So I
more importantly, my husband. So I'm also a mompreneur wife.
Correct.
Yeah. So the priority is the relationship with husband. That's again where the children will get to see the foundations of a relationship and what it takes to work out relationships, like sometimes when we bicker or argue and how we work things out.
Correct.
Don't ever forget that, because sometimes we might be too busy, sometimes we might be too caught up with the things that we do on a day-to-day basis, but a hug or a kiss or a cuddle really only takes that few seconds. And do that with your family, every single member, every single day.
Yes.
That's my message to finish off for today, Kenneth.
Yes, thank you, Wan Pin. Thank you for those who came in live. Thank you for this first episode. Coming in and support.
Yes.
So I will see you guys in the next episode. I'm Mother Industry Live. Kenneth signing off. See ya.
Thank you. Bye. Offline liao ah. Oh. My dad was watching, seriously. You okay? Go and get some water. Yep. Next time when you do your live